All right, in today's video, I want to take a look at gold. I think we've got at least a daily cycle low, and there's an outside possibility that maybe we've completed an intermediate cycle low. So my original expectation is that we're going to need one more daily cycle here, and that the move out of this daily cycle low, and remember I said the FOMC meeting was potentially one of the trigger events that could mark that bottom, and it looks like it was. So my assumption at the moment is that this is gonna right translate and give us 5 to 8 day rally, and then gold is gonna roll over, come down, break below this, and make a lower low. Now this is what would have to happen to change my mind. This resistance zone here at about 1835. If gold breaks through that on this rally, then I'm going to change my mind, and I'm going to say that this is a larger degree intermediate cycle low. And then if that happens, then we have an opportunity to change this pattern of lower intermediate highs. So let me expand this chart just a touch. All right, so you can see here is an intermediate top. This is a lower intermediate top. This is another lower intermediate top. So we've got a pattern of lower lows, or lower highs. If we can break that pattern of lower highs, then I would say that we've either started a new 8 year cycle, or this 8 year cycle is going to make a higher high before rolling over. So this is my line in the sand right here. This is what changes my mind, is a move back above 1835. Let's see if I can draw that in. All right, something else I'm watching. As I've noted in the past, during the advancing phase of an intermediate cycle, RSI tends to turn back down pretty quickly once it gets overbought. So I'm kind of watching what's happening here, because we're already getting overbought on gold. If it can't hold this overbought condition and turns back down quickly, then that would be an indication that this would be a third daily cycle that's going to left translate, come down, and make a lower low below this, and probably test or marginally break below this pivot as well. So something I'm watching pretty closely here, right? We're already getting overbought, and if we start to turn back down, then that would be an indication that this daily cycle's left translating. However, if we continue to rally, especially next week, and this RSI starts to get embed in the overbought condition, then I'm going to give it the benefit of the doubt, and especially if we can get above 1835, then that signals that something different is happening, and that this may be a larger degree intermediate cycle low, and then at that point we have a real opportunity to make a higher intermediate high. Now let me move to the currencies. All right, so as most of you know, in my previous videos, I noted that this is certainly a 3 year cycle low in the dollar. I think it was probably artificially terminated a little bit early. I think if allowed to run naturally, we probably would have come down, made a little bit lower low, maybe a full test of this pivot right here before our 3 year cycle low was printed, but the ECB has been trying to keep the euro suppressed against the dollar, and that's basically what's happening here. The euro is moving inversely to the dollar. Here's another indication that this market isn't really trading freely. This is a major resistance and support zone. This intermediate cycle was really stretched already and mature. There's no way that this was going to go through that kind of resistance zone this late in an intermediate cycle, not naturally. So this is, and also, you know, I've said this many times in the past, the currencies are the most manipulated markets in the world. And that's what's happening here, is that the ECB is trying to keep the euro suppressed against the dollar, and they're trying to prop the dollar up. So the dollar went through this basically on its more or less first try, and we got sustained follow through, which again, I don't think there's any way this would have happened naturally, not this late in an intermediate cycle. But these manipulated moves, at some point they tend to the natural forces take over, and then they get reversed. So that may be what's happening here. So here's something else I want to watch. I think this, and it's really hard to tell on the currencies anymore, what is a normal daily cycle. The cycles have been warped so badly by the manipulation that it's, they don't even really work very well, but I'm going to give it, again, I'll give it the benefit of the doubt. So I really don't know whether to call this a daily cycle low, or this is one really long daily cycle, and it's, either way though, you can see we're trying to break this daily cycle uptrend line, which would that would make me think that this is not a daily cycle low, because obviously it didn't break that uptrend line. We're trying to break it now, so I'm going to say this is a daily cycle that's trying to move down into a daily cycle low. If this really starts to accelerate lower, and if it breaks back below this support and resistance line, that would be an indication to me that the manipulation in the currencies is trying to break, and if that's the case, then perhaps this three-year cycle is topping, and we're getting ready to start the declining phase of this three-year cycle. And if that would be the case, then this would be a left translating three-year cycle, which would be, of course, very bearish. And it would come right when everyone is expecting the exact opposite there. They're expecting the Fed to start taper, and taper faster than expected, and to raise rates. And if the dollar does the exact opposite, well, very often that's exactly what happens, is that the dollar starts to do the, or an asset starts to do the exact opposite of what the so-called fundamentals would suggest would happen. So it's possible that that, you know, this rally has already discounted all of the actions by the Fed, and none of that is going to save the dollar. And it's possible that this was the news that caused this three-year cycle to top, and now we've got about 2 years to work its way down into its next three-year cycle low, and that should, especially if this is left translating right here, it should break below this low. So back to gold. So again, my expectations are that gold will not be able to get through this resistance zone before left translating, coming back down and making a lower low. If it does, then I'm gonna change my expectations 180 degrees, and at that point, I think there's a very good chance that we could gold could make a higher high here and break this pattern of lower intermediate highs, and then in that case, then I would think that gold would continue higher while the dollar starts its move down into its next three-year cycle low, which means that gold could continue higher all the way into early to mid 2023. So we'll just have to see what plays out. There is another sort of bullish sign in that the double mining funds, JNUG and Nugget, had some pretty heavy volume in the last couple days. That can sometimes signal an intermediate bottom, so I'm expecting this to turn down at this resistance point. It will almost certainly at least take a break and maybe hit that turn down and then come back up. But if this breaks, then I'm gonna start to get really bullish on gold. And if we can, and if it can make a higher intermediate high, then I think that's a sign that the 3-year cycle in the dollar is topped, and gold has probably got a couple of years to rally, and it's gonna break this pattern of lower intermediate lows and go much higher over the next couple of years anyway. So we'll see what happens. Right now I'm expecting it to turn down from here. If it breaks through that, then I'm gonna become very bullish on the metals. Right now, stocks are kind of stuck in a really volatile, probably a sideways consolidation. So right now what appears to be working is metals, maybe energy as well, we'll have to see. The baby bull in commodities is over, so commodity trading is going to become a little bit more difficult. But I think we're starting a phase here anyway where you can at least make some money short term in gold, and maybe we completed an intermediate cycle low here. If so, then we've got 2 to 4 months before this intermediate cycle tops. But this is my line in the sand right there. We're going to watch this closely and see if gold can break that.